Hi, in this video we will discuss about operation of BJT. What is BJT? BJT is a bipolar junction transistor. Why it is called as BJT? In BJT, current is due to both majority and minority charge carriers, that's why it is bipolar device. In BJT we have the two junctions, that's why it is bipolar junction device, and it transfers resistance from one level to another level, so that's why it is a transistor. By combining all these three, means conduction is due to both majority and minority, so that's why bipolar device. It is consisting of junctions, bipolar junction device, and it transfers resistance from one level to another level, that's why it is called as bipolar junction transistor. What are the types of the BJTs? Types of BJT. We have two types. Types of BJT. We have two types. One is NPN transistor and another one is PNP transistor. What is the difference between NPN and PNP transistor? To understand this, BJT is a three-terminal device. That means it is consisting of three terminals or three layers. What are the three? One is emitter, and second one is base, and third one is collector. Suppose if you go to this PNP transistor, it could be like this. This region is emitter region and this region is base region and remaining is collector. So it is emitter, this is base terminal and this is collector terminal. PNP. Basically this emitter region is emitted out, that's why you can take this as P plus. Suppose if you go to NPN transistor, emitter, this base and this one is collector. So NPN means N plus PN. Why N plus? Emitter is really doped, base is lightly doped, and collector is moderately doped, size is large. The size of the collector is large. Okay. Why emitter is heavily doped? This is heavily doped. Moderate in size. It is heavily doped to perform the transistor action. What is meant by transistor action? Transistor action is nothing but how efficiently emitter transport the charge carriers from its region to the collector region. If it transfers or if it transports more number of charge carriers to the collector region, then we can say it is having excellent transistor action. In order to transport more number of charge carriers, it should be heavily doped. Next, coming to the base, base is lightly doped and size is small in size, or width of the base is very small. Why it is lightly doped? Transistor action means what? Emitter should emit charge carriers, collector should collect that emitted charge carriers. Before entering this emitted charge carriers into the collector region, we have a region called base region. If it is moderately doped or heavily doped, then these charge carriers can easily recombine with the majority charge carriers in this region. What are the majority charge carriers in this region for NPN? If these electrons are majority in the emitter region. If these are injected into this region, holes here we have more. So if they are equivalent, all can recombine in the base region only. No charge carriers can cross the that base region and enter into the collector region. If it is rightly doped, recombination in the base region is less, and as recombination is less, this emitter charge carriers can cross this base region and entering into the that collector region, means we will get excellent transistor action if base is rightly doped. Next, coming to the collector is moderately doped, and size is large in size. We will discuss why it is moderately doped later at the concept when we will discuss about that the concept called base width modulation. Coming to this size, why it is large in size? It is for transistor action. Emitter base junction, the junction between emitter and base is called as emitter junction. The junction between collector and base is called as the collector junction. For transistor action, emitter junction is forward bias and collector junction is reverse bias. As it is operated in the reverse bias we have the reverse current, that is due to the temperature effect. So that means there will be heating effect when it is operated at the greater reverse voltages, and here more number of charge carriers emitted from the emitter region. Due to this, we will get a large current in the collector region. Because of that large current, power will be more. Because of that power will be dissipated as heat. To reduce damage of the transistor because of the dissipated power, we need to consider this size or region of this collector should be large. If it is large, more power will be dissipated to surroundings and we can protect our transistor. That's why collector is large in size to dissipate the power or heat to the surroundings, and emitter is heavily doped to supply large number of charge carriers. Base is lightly doped in order to reduce the recombinations. So this is all about what construction details of our BJT. We have two types of the transistor, NPN and PNP. Now we will discuss about operation of PNP transistor in active mode. Active mode means what? Emitter junction is forward biased. Emitter junction means what? Junction between emitter and the base. Collector junction means what? Junction between collector and the base. In active mode of transistor, emitter junction is forward biased, collector junction is reverse biased. In that condition, we will discuss about the current components in BJT. So, let us discuss about current components in PNP transistor. PNP and PNP. What is meant by PNP transistor? Emitter is P region. That means our transistor is looking like this. So this is our emitter region and this is collector region. This region and this region is base region. This is our base region. It is PNP. Emitter is heavily doped. That's why we consider as P plus. And what is meant by active mode of operation? The junction between emitter and base is called as emitter junction. So that is emitter junction. It should be forward biased. Forward biasing of emitter junction means what? P type should be connected to the positive terminal of the battery. And N-type should be connected to the negative terminal of the battery. It is forward biasing of the emitter junction. Next we have the junction between collector and the base. We have a junction between collector and base. So this junction should be reverse biased. The JE should be forward biased like this. This is forward biased, and the JC should be reverse biased. So reverse biasing of this one is nothing but what? Reverse biasing means what? N should be connected to the positive terminal of the battery, and this P should be connected to the negative terminal of the battery. It is reverse biasing of the collector junction. Collector junction is reverse biased, and this one positive negative. This is what? Forward biasing of emitter junction. Now let us discuss about forward biasing of this emitter base junction or emitter junction. So it is forward biased means this P is connected to the positive terminal of the battery. So what are the majority charge carriers in this P? Holes. Holes get repelled by the positive terminal of the battery, and holes are moving in this direction and giving a hole current in the emitter region, that is current due to the holes in the emitter region, that is IP. These holes get repelled by this positive terminal of the battery, and holes are more in this region compared to in this region. Because of this, holes can diffuse from emitter region to the base region and giving a current, that is what? IP. Holes are moving in this direction, and current direction is also along the holes. Next, this negative terminal of the battery is connected to the N type region, that is base region. What are the majority charge carriers in the N region? Electrons. Electrons get repelled by the negative terminal of the battery, and electrons are moving in this direction. Holes are moving in this direction, and electrons are moving in this direction, and electron current direction is like this. So that is what? I N E. So that means in the emitter region we have the currents. So that is what? I P E and I N E. So that is emitter current is nothing but what? Total emitter current. Current in the emitter region I E equal to I P E plus I N E. So this I N E is negligible compared to the I P E, because emitter region is heavily doped. That means whole current is more compared to this electron current in the emitter region, because it is lightly doped. That means less number of electrons compared to the holes in the emitter region. Next, as holes are entering into this base region, these holes can find electrons and recombine with that electrons. But electrons are less in number compared to holes entering into this region, because this base is lightly doped. This base is lightly doped. That means if 100 holes enter into this base region, out of that 100, only 1-5% will be recombined with the electrons. Remaining 95-99% of holes can reach this collector region and giving a current in the collector region. That current is due to these holes. Holes from emitter to base region, and after that base to collector. So that's why it is the current in the collector region due to holes injected from emitter to base, after that injected into the collector. So that's why here we have a whole current in the collector region, that is IPC. Total current is IPE. Out of that IPE we will get IPC. That means remaining current is what? If you subtract this IPC from IPE, we will get a remaining current. That is what? Recombination current in the base region. That is nothing but what? If this one is going in this direction, remaining current will be going in this direction. That is nothing but what? IPE. I will write that recombination current here. So that is what? IPE minus IPC. So that is the current in the base region. That is the current in the base region. So it is about forward biasing of emitter junction. Now consider reverse bias of this collector junction. If there exists a reverse bias, there is a possibility of what? Formation of depletion region. What is meant by depletion region? Depletion region is nothing but a region consisting of immobile ions, means negative immobile ions on P side, negative immobile ions on P side, and positive immobile ions on N side. Due to this, an electric field is induced. What is the function of this electric field? This electric field can sweep the minority charge carriers through the junction. So here we have the junction that is reverse bias region, that is B and N. So it is collector region, it is base region. Because of this electric field, minority charge carriers can drift from this region to this region and this region to this region. What are the minority charge carriers in this N region? What are the minority charge carriers in this region? So minority charge carriers in this N region are nothing but holes. Holes are moving in this direction and giving a hole current in the collector region, and it is due to the reverse bias. That's why I consider IBC not hole current in the collector region due to reverse bias. And already we studied reverse saturation current, that is affected due to temperature only. So that is IBC not. Next, and what are the minority charge carriers in the P region? That are nothing but electrons. Electrons are moving. Electrons can be sweep out by this field in this direction. Electrons can sweep out in this direction, and electron current is opposite to the electron direction and giving an electron current in the collector region. So electron current in the collector region INC, and it is the reverse current. So that's why INC not. So thus in the collector region we have the reverse current, that is IC, is nothing but what? IC not, reverse current. Reverse current is taken as I not, and it is in the collector region. So that's why IC naught is nothing but INC naught plus IBC naught. By combining these two, we will get what? IC naught. Finally, we got current components in the emitter region as what? IE. In the emitter region, we have IE is equal to what? IBE plus INE, electron current and over current. Of course, it is negligible. And in the base region, we have recombination current, so that is what? IBE minus IBC. And in the collector region, we have the IBE is injected current into the base region. Out of this recombination current, we got as IBE minus IBC. That means remaining current is IBC. And the reverse saturation current is IC0, where IC0 is nothing but what? IPC naught plus INC naught. Now, whatever the relationship between emitter current, base current, and collector current, if you see here, we have forward bias. Because of this forward biasing of emitter junction, holes are moving in this direction. Holes are moving in this direction and giving an emitter current. The current direction is like this. That means emitter current, our emitter current is. Emitter current is moving in this direction. Next, here it is reverse bias. Because of this reverse bias, holes get holes attracted by this negative terminal and giving a collector current IC, like this IC, and IC is coming in this direction. If you take this as the super node, some X, and if you apply KCL at this place, you will get current directions like this, that is IC and IE, and what about IB? IB is coming like this. Holes are coming like this. RS, here we are losing some electrons due to recombination. That electrons can be supplied by this supply. Electrons are moving in this direction, means current is moving opposite to this electron direction and giving a current direction like this, that is IB. So that means if you apply KCL at this node, IB is coming like this, that means reaching towards this node, IC is reaching towards this node, whereas IE is leaving that node. Finally, KCL at this node X, we will get IE is leaving and IB is towards the node and IC also towards the node. Finally, we got IE equal to IB plus IC. So this is all about current components. First, in the emitter region, holes for PNP transistor, holes injected into the base region giving a current IBE. And next, electrons are moving in this direction and giving a current INE. Thus, in the emitter region, we have a current IE as IBE plus INE. And if these holes injected into the base region, not entire volts recombined with the electrons in the base region, because as it is lightly doped, few volts, few of them only recombined, remaining will cross the junction and reaching the collector region and giving a current IPC. Total current is IP, and here we have current in the collector region IPC, means remaining current is flowing through the base region. That current is recombination current, so that is nothing but what IPE minus IPC. So this is the base current, IPE minus IPC. We will see. And coming to the reverse pass, in case of the reverse pass, we have what? A field is induced. Because of that induced field, minor to charge carriers can drift across the junction. So due to this, we have reverse current. That reverse current is nothing but IC naught. That is due to the holes and electrons. IC naught equal to IPC naught plus INC naught. And if you want to get the relationship between emitter current and collector current and base current, you need to apply KCL at this node. And if you see, holes are moving in this direction, that means emitter current is leaving this node, and here holes are coming in this direction, means collector current is coming like this, that means reaching this node towards the node. So IC is reaching this node, and IB is also reaching this node, and IE is leaving. Finally, we got relationship as I equal to IB plus IC. This is all about the operation of the transistor and current components in the transistor. And we can draw the symbols of the transistor also. We can draw symbols of transistor. So let us take this as base, this as collector, and this as emitter. So then, suppose if it is PNP transistor, PNP transistor, then emitter current direction, emitter base junction is forward bias, this is forward bias, forward current means P to N only, like this. Arrow symbol indicates current direction, like this, P to N. Suppose if it is NPN transistor, NPN means this is base, this is our emitter, and this is our collector. NPN, NPN. Current direction is always from P to N, means arrow direction, P to N, like this. So this is what? This is PNP transistor. Sorry, it is NPN transistor, and it is PNP transistor. So this is the symbol of NPN transistor, and it is the symbol of PNP transistor. Arrow at the emitter terminal. So this indicates current direction from P to N. And here, PN. Okay, current direction is always like this, P to N, and here P to N. Clear?